Good morning, children. We have to learn about era of Gandhi, the last part of this lesson. Now we have learned about Jawaharlal Nehru. Jawaharlal Nehru is known as the architect of modern India. Architect means Shilpi. Jawaharlal Nehru is known as the Shilpi or architect of modern India. Jawaharlal Nehru was the first Prime Minister of India. He was the first Prime Minister of India. We should learn about Jawaharlal Nehru. Then what is that? We have to learn or understand about Jawaharlal Nehru. Jawaharlal Nehru entered into Indian politics through Home Rule movement. One day I had told you what is the meaning of Home Rule movement before studying this lesson. Home Rule movement means it was started by Bala Gangadhar Tilak and Annie Besant. Bala Gangadhar Tilak and Annie Besant started Home Rule movement. Two members, Annie Besant and Bala Gangadhar Tilak, at the same time started separate Home Rule movement. The Home Rule movement of Bala Gangadhar Tilak was located in Maharashtra or Pune, and the center of Annie Besant's Home Rule movement was in Madras or Pasang Chennai. Both of them worked hard for the freedom of India. That means both of them demanded that India should be ruled by Indians only. There is Home Rule movement. And in the Home Rule movement, Jawaharlal Nehru actively participated. In the Home Rule movement. Then, during 1923, non-cooperation movement was there in the land of India. During the 1920s, non-cooperation movement was there in the land of India. Jawaharlal Nehru actively participated in the non-cooperation movement of independence, movement of British India. Then, during the time of non-cooperation movement, what had actually happened that we have studied? During the non-cooperation movement, teachers left the schools and colleges. Advocates left the court. Government employees left their government jobs. This was the condition. And non-cooperation movement was the biggest mass movement that happened in India before the Quit India movement. It was the biggest mass movement that happened in India before the Quit India movement. Quit India movement happened in 1942. Quit India movement was the biggest mass movement that happened in India. Before Quit India movement, non-cooperation movement was the biggest mass movement that happened in the land of India. Jawaharlal Nehru participated in the non-cooperation movement. And at the Lahore meeting of International Congress, Jawaharlal Nehru was elected as the President of the Congress. In that meeting, the idea
Indriya of Purna Swaraj was required.
Purna Swaraj means
India want complete freedom. That was known as Purna Swaraj.
In that meeting,
the idea of Purna Swaraj was declared.
That means
India want complete freedom or full freedom.
That was the meaning of Purna Swaraj.
Then, Jawaharlal Nehru believed in communist ideology or in socialist ideology also. When Mahatma Gandhi withdrew non-cooperation movement, Nehru became very angry. Nehru did not like all the ideas of Nehru. Nehru did not like all the ideas or ideologies of Gandhi. Then, during the 49th meeting of International Congress, Nehru was elected as the president of Indian National Congress. He believed that Chakka and Harijan movements were not so effective, who told Nehru told. Chakka movement and Harijan movements were the movements which were started by Gandhi. Jawaharlal Nehru told that Chakka movement and Harijan movements are not so effective as we are thinking now.
Chakka movements and Harijan movements were not so effective
as we are thinking now. This was the idea of Nehru. But as a great leader, Nehru respected the abilities of Gandhiji. Nehru was an audacious leader, or Nehru was a great reader. He used to read so many books. And Nehru was inspired by, or Nehru was influenced by so many ideas or ideologies. Nehru was ready to accept all the ideas and ideologies. Then, it was Nehru who developed the idea of non-aligned movement. Non-aligned movement means not joining either with Russia or with America. Standing independently, that is non-aligned movement. He made the idea of mixed economy. Mixed economy means this is a mixture of communism and capitalism. This was the idea of Nehru. After independence, all the states of India got the power or right to join either with India or with Pakistan. Some states of India, mainly Kashmir, Junagadh, Hyderabad, etc., were not ready to join with India. So it was Nehru and Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel who joined those states with India. That activity was known as integration of the states of India. That activity was known as integration of Indian states. Sardar Patel has been known as the Iron Man of India. Sardar Patel. Sardar Patel is known as the Iron Man of India because it was Sardar Patel who integrated, who joined together those Indian states which were not ready to join with India. Then, after independence, one major question was there. After independence, one main or major question was there. That question was, what we have to do with Indian states? Some people demanded that, some people, we need not divide India into states on the basis of language. Some people demanded. Some people demanded that there is no need of dividing India into so many states on the basis of language. Some people clearly told that language based division of India into so many states will develop regionalism in the land of India. People of one state may say that they are superior to the people of another state. But Nehru did not accept these views. Nehru was not ready to accept these opinions. It was Nehru who divided India into so many states on the basis of language. That is known as language-based reorganization policy. Language-based reorganization policy was made by Nehru. So now we do have 28 states in India and so many union territories. This was the idea of Nehru in the beginning. Then Nehru believed that complete industrialization will bring development in India. What he told? Nehru had his own ideas regarding the development of India. Nehru believed that complete industrialization. Nehru believed that only complete industrialization will bring development of India. That was the idea of Nehru. He tried to develop India through 5-year plans. 5-year plan means a plan that will be completed within a period of 5 years. It was Soviet Union or Russia. It was Soviet Union Russia who started 5-year plan for the first time in the land of India. Soviet Union or Russia started a 5-year plan for the first time in the land of India. Soviet Union or Russia. Then what happened? Jawaharlal Nehru bore out the idea of 5-year plans from Russia. He told that if India want to develop, we want 5-year plans. So Jawaharlal Nehru introduced 5-year plans in India for the all-round development of India as a whole. Then atomic energy development. Jawaharlal Nehru believed that atomic energy department we have to start. He told atomic energy department we have to start. That was the idea of Nehru. For that he laid the foundation of atomic energy department with H.J. Baba. He was a famous scientist. Now also we are doing so many experiments in the field of atomic energy development. It was Jawaharlal Nehru who started atomic energy development in the land of India. Non-aligned movement. After Second World War, I will tell you detail. After Second World War, the world was divided into two blocks, Russian bloc and American bloc. The world was divided into Russian bloc and American bloc. All the communist countries or socialist countries were with Russia. All the capitalist countries were with America. That means the world was divided into two blocks, two groups, after Second World War. But Nehru told that we need not join with the Russian bloc or with American bloc. We will stand alone. We will stand alone. That was the idea of Jawaharlal Nehru. Jawaharlal Nehru was the founder of non-alignment movement. Indonesia, Ghana, Egypt. All these nations later joined with Nehru. It was the brainchild of Jawaharlal Nehru, the idea of non-alignment movement. Panchasila principles. China is a neighboring country of India. Thank you. China is a neighboring country of India. Now also China and India do have their own problems, China and India. So, the then Prime Minister of China was Chou Enlai. Chou Enlai and Nehru signed in one agreement. That agreement was known as Panchasila principle. India and China signed in one agreement. That was known as Panchasila principle. According to that agreement, what happened? China and India agreed that they will work together as brothers. India will not attack China, China will not attack India. Mutual cooperation there will be between China and India. They will cooperate each other. There was a condition. They will cooperate each other. So, it was Jawaharlal Nehru who took initiative in forming Panchasila principle. Panchasila principles are the guiding principle in between China and India. So, Jawaharlal Nehru has been known as the architect or Shilpi of modern India. During 1964 he died. It was Jawaharlal Nehru who laid the industrial development of India. He told that handicraft industries of India should be developed. Those industries which are functioning, with the human or handicraft industries should be developed. He told cottage industries should be developed. Cottage industries are those industries which are there in the cottage or house. In cottage industries, all the members of the house can participate. In cottage industries, all the members of the house can participate. And small scale industries are those industries which are not demanding more investment. Then, large scale industries, iron steel, shipbuilding industry, aircraft manufacturing industry, automobile industry, all these industries are known as basic and key industries. Medium industries are those industries which are demanding medium investment. And Jawaharlal Nehru told that all these industries should be developed. Jawaharlal Nehru made programs for the all-round industrial development of India. Then, rural development. Jawaharlal Nehru worked hard for the agriculture or rural development of India. He told like Gandhi that India's Atma or soul is there in the village. So, in order to solve the problems of agriculture, Jawaharlal Nehru made so many programs. Jawaharlal Nehru made so many programs for the agriculture development of India also. for solving poverty badatana and unemployment also. Jawaharlal Nehru made so many programs for India as a whole. See, dear children, we have studied the lesson era of Gandhi or the period of Gandhi, Gandhian period. In this lesson, we studied in detail about Gandhi, and in this lesson, we are studying in detail about other great personalities of India also. We are studying about other great personalities of India also. Now we have to study about Jawaharlal Nehru. For the last 6 days, we have been learning or we have been studying about the lesson era of Gandhi. Jawaharlal Nehru is one of the greatest sons of modern India. Jawaharlal Nehru joined with India's freedom struggle during the time of Home Rule movement of India. Last day, I had told you children clearly what was there with the Home Rule movement. Two people of India started Home Rule movement in India. Two people. One was Ani Besant. Ani Besant was an Irish lady. Irish means she came from Ireland. Ani Besant was an Irish lady. Ani Besant worked hard for the freedom of India. It was Ani Besant who started one Home Rule movement. Her headquarters was Chennai, Old Madras. Another person was Bala Gangadhar Tilak. Bala Gangadhar Tilak also started Home Rule movement. His center of activity was Pune in Maharashtra. Both of them were punished by the British people severely. Ani Besant and Bala Gangadhar Tilak were punished by the British people severely. Then, during the time of Home Rule movement, Jawaharlal Nehru joined with the Indian National Congress and with the Freedom Movement of India. Then, non-cooperation movement took place during the year 1920. During that time also, Jawaharlal Nehru participated in the freedom struggle of India. At the Lahore meeting of Indian National Congress, Jawaharlal Nehru was elected as the president of INC or Indian National Congress. Lahore meeting had one speciality. It was in the Lahore meeting that the idea of Purna Swaraj was declared. The idea of Purna Swaraj was declared during the time of Lahore meeting of Indian National Congress. So, Lahore meeting is having its own historical importance when we are studying about the freedom struggle of India. Then, Jawaharlal Nehru did not join with the ideologies of Gandhiji really. Jawaharlal Nehru told that Charkha movement, Harijan movements, these two movements were started by Gandhi. These two movements were not so effective. Who told Gandhiji? Nehru told. But he did not fight with Gandhi. Nehru accepted the best sides of the human personality of Gandhi. Or Nehru accepted the great personality of Gandhi as a freedom fighter and as a spiritual leader of India. Nehru believed in communist ideologies. At the 49th session of Hindu National Congress, at the 49th meeting or session of Indian National Congress, Nehru was elected as the president of Indian National Congress. Nehru was able to guide Indian National Congress as the president of Indian National Congress. Then he was an instrumental force. He was very powerful in the days of non-aligned movement. Non-aligned movement means not joining either with Russia or with America. Mixed economy is an idea in which socialism and communism will exist side by side. That is mixed economy. India is a mixed economy. It was the idea of Nehru. Then, during 1947, India got freedom. During 1947 period, India got freedom. During that time, some states of India were not ready to join with India. Some states. For example, Junagadh in Gujarat, Kashmir, then Hyderabad areas. They were not ready to join with India. It was Nehru who joined those states with India. Nehru. Along with Nehru, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel was there. Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel was the first Home Minister of India. Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel has been known as the Iron Man of India. So, integration of Indian states were achieved by Nehru and Patel. Then, after independence, one question was there. What we have to do with the Indian states? That was the question. What we can do with the Indian states? That was the question. Some people argued that we should not divide India on the basis of language. It will develop regionalism in the land of India. That was the opinion of some leaders. But Nehru told that we have to divide India on the basis of language. So, language-based reorganization of Indian states. Language-based reorganization of Indian states were achieved by Nehru. Now we have our own states. This was the policy of Nehru. Then, Nehru believed that for the development of India, what we have to do? Nehru believed that for the development of India, industrialization is a must. This was the idea of Nehru. Nehru believed or told that for the industrial development or for the industrialization of India, there will be development or for the development of India as a whole, we want industrialization inside India. Then 5 year plans. It was Soviet Union who started 5 year plans for the first time in the land of the world. It was Soviet Union who introduced 5 year plan in the world for the first time. Jawaharlal Nehru copied the idea of 5 year plans from Russia and implemented in the land of India. Nehru believed that 5 year plans alone will provide impetus or encouragement of development in India. Through 5 year plans, agriculture, industries, trade and commerce of India began to develop. Through 5 year plans. Then Nehru believed that we have to produce atomic energy. Then only India can develop. He laid the foundation of atomic energy along with a great Indian scientist, H.J. Baba. So it was Nehru who laid the foundation of non-aligned movement. What is the meaning of this one? I will tell you in detail. What is the meaning of non-aligned movement? That means during 1939, Second World War broke out. It completed in the year 1945. After Second World War, the world was divided into two. That is, American bloc and Russian bloc. All the socialist countries were with Russia. All the capitalist countries were with America. So, during this time, Nehru told that we will not join either with America or with Russia. We will stand alone. That movement is known as non-aligned movement. Nehru was the founder of non-aligned movement. Panchasila principle. India and China agreed or signed in one principle that is known as Panchasila principle. Chiang Kai-shek was the then Prime Minister of China. Nehru was the Prime Minister of India during that time. Both of the nations signed in one agreement known as Panchasila principle. According to Panchasila principle, China and India decided to solve all their problems in a peaceful way. China and India decided to cooperate each other. China and India decided to share their disputes in a peaceful way. It was Nehru, Jawaharlal Nehru, who took initiative, who took encouragement in framing Panchasila principle. Then Nehru told that for the development of India, we want industrial development. Nehru told that handicraft industries are there. Those industries which are working without machine, those industries which are working with human labor, that should be developed. Cottage industries should be developed. Cottage industries means those industries which are working inside the house, quota industries. Small scale industries are those industries. For the development of small scale industries, only small amount of money is enough. Nehru told that small scale industries should be developed. Then, large scale industries are those industries. For the starting of large scale industries, we want huge amount of money. Medium industries are those industries. For the starting of those industries, we want only medium amount of money. Nehru told that from handicraft industry to basic and key industries, development is a must. Without industrial development, he told, it is impossible for India to develop. Then, rural development of India. We had studied about the ideas of Gandhi. Gandhi told that India's Atma or India's soul is in the villages. For the development of India, we want the development of rural areas and agricultural sector of India. Nehru also agreed with the idea of whom? Gandhi. Nehru made so many plans and programs for the overall development of the agricultural field of India. He made programs in order to remove unemployment, poverty, illiteracy, etc. from the village areas of India. So, dear children, you observe this video. Read the same topic in your textbook. Try to understand the topic. If you do have more doubts, please children, please you call me. Thank you.